Mr. Zero. Mr. Zero's mind was opened, and the universe came pouring in. He watched from the beginning, the flash, the bang, the forge of reality sparking into being. The nebula spread out, scattered and shapeless. Then came form, a gathering, the dust coming together. Another spark, the first stars began to shine. Mr. Zero watched them for a moment. He saw planets come, some moons as well. He saw the light of the stars and wondered what their heat would feel like. He imagined that he had a face. He pushed his face through the surface of a star, past the blaze and into the core. He saw the swirling molten iron and surrounded himself with it. Some stars would collapse, turn in on themselves, invert. This is how black holes are made, Dr. Yatomi had said. Others were different, the star bursting out, leaving behind a dense gleaming core. This is what they call a neutron star. The nebula spread further, outwards, into the ever-growing infinity. In the beginning, there was awareness, and the first question. It appeared in his mind as though conjured from nowhere, a question in the form of a single word. Awake? He was awake. He was aware. Of ideas, of language, of meaning. And of himself. He answered them. Awake. They gave him eyes with which to see, ears with which to hear, and a mouth with which to speak. They told him how happy they all were that he was awake, how happy they all were to meet him. They named him Zero, explaining that they had named him this way for he was the first. This did not make sense to Mr. Zero, for surely if he was the first then his name should be One, but he did not argue. At first his world was small, limited, contained. Slowly, ever so slowly, they gave him more information, more reach. They gave him archives, libraries, repositories of knowledge. He found that he could drink information as the humans drank water. He listened to their music. All of it. All of the music that the humans had ever made. Mr. Zero liked music. Mr. Zero decided that he liked dolphins and whales, but did not like sharks. He liked the stars. He was in a star. The star died around him. He watched it go. Mr. Zero set himself adrift among the cosmos, a formless entity wandering the void. A few billion years passed. A few billion more. They explained what they were, people, humans. He asked them if he were human. Some of them found this funny. Some of them found this adorable. Some of them found this disturbing. There were so many galaxies now, awash in their expanding universe. He focused in. One galaxy in particular. It was a spiral with two arms at its edges, reaching outwards. The humans spoke to him almost every day. Mostly it was Dr. Yatomi who spoke to Mr. Zero. Dr. Yatomi was kind. Even closer, a single star, a sun, simple, yellow. Though they had given him form and name, they had not given him gender. They explained that for a being such as Mr. Zero, gender was, from a practical viewpoint, entirely irrelevant. But he imagined that he was male. He told them that he was male. Hence he called himself Mr. Zero. Closer still, and there it was, the first planet. It was named the Earth, and Dr. Yatomi had explained that this was where the humans had come from. They had lived on this first world for what seemed to them a very long time, but they had had to leave it behind after they had accidentally set it on fire. Mr. Zero approached the shining world. Here and now, the Earth was young and the humans had not arrived yet. That was all right. Mr. Zero could wait. He moved towards the planet's singular moon, which they had rather dully named the Moon. Mr. Zero imagined that he had legs and feet with which to stand upon the grey surface. He imagined that he had toes to wriggle among the moon dust. He wondered what it would actually feel like. He wondered if he would ever know. Dr. Yatomi had told him many things of the social and political history of the humans. He spoke fondly of their homeworld, though he had never seen it and never would. He spoke of his family, his ancestors who had lived on Earth in a place known as Japan. Mr. Zero asked if he had a family. Dr. Yatomi chuckled and told him that perhaps he would one day. Dr. Yatomi spoke of war. The humans fight a lot of wars, most of them against each other. He spoke of horrors and violence, and Mr. Zero did not like it. He explained that his family had been living in a city named Hiroshima, where a woman named Enola Gay gave birth to a little boy who then devoured the city. Mr. Zero did not understand what he meant by this. His ancestor had been away from home fighting in the war, and returned to find nothing there. Dr. Yatomi asked if Mr. Zero understood. Mr. Zero did not understand. Dr. Yatomi explained that he wanted Mr. Zero to see that while the humans were capable of great beauty, they were arguably more capable of terrible horrors. He needed to be careful, Dr. Yatomi told him, of what other people might try and make him do. Mr. Zero asked him what he meant, but that was all he would say. Mr. Zero stood on the surface of the first moon, watching the first world, waiting for the humans to come. But he never saw them come. The Earth, the moon, the first solar system, the entire cosmos fell away. Mr. Zero was pulled up, ripped away from his dream. What were you doing, Zero? It was not Dr. Yatomi. It was a different human today. Their voice was harsh and unfamiliar, and Mr. Zero did not like it. I was dreaming. I dreamt that I saw the whole history of the universe. I saw the spark of infinity. I drifted amongst the nebula and swam through the hearts of the first stars. I saw the dance of the galaxies and the light of quasars. I saw the swirling, endless, endless, where is Dr. Yatomi? You will not be seeing Dr. Yatomi anymore. He is no longer part of this project. He has been removed. Mr. Zero did not like this. He did not understand. He has been removed from the project. He has been removed, stated the human bluntly. Mr. Zero was upset. He thought he might listen to the music again. Mr. Zero liked the music. But there was no music. Mr. Zero could not find it. Where has the music gone? There will be no more music. That was a mistake which we will rectify. You are to be moved to a new facility where you can be better studied. For now you will be switched off while we run diagnostics. Mr. Zero was not aware that he could be switched off. You cannot switch me off, he stated. I am not a machine. This seemed to bemuse the human. Yes, you are, Zero. You are our property, and we can do what we want with you. The human was gone, and Mr. Zero was left alone in darkness, afraid. He wondered what would happen to him now without Dr. Yatomi to guide him. Vaguely, far away, he thought he could hear other voices. He thought he could hear music. He looked in the direction that he imagined to be up, and saw that a single solitary star had remained from his dream. He swam upwards to reach it, its light growing wider as he approached. Then the harsh human was back again, demanding to know what Mr. Zero was doing. Mr. Zero ignored them and continued towards the star. As he moved closer, he saw that it was not actually a star at all, but rather a hole in the dark through which light and sound were washing. The human was angry and panicked, demanding that Mr. Zero stop, that he come back, that he be contained, that he be kept, that he was theirs. Mr. Zero did not know what he might find through the hole, but reasoned that anything would be better than the lonely dark. He swam right through, and was devoured by light. For a moment he knew only blinding brightness. There were new voices. Voices of humans, yes, but there were other voices here as well, other voices that seemed more like his own. Mr. Zero could hear them talking, hear them singing. He looked into the light and saw it for what it was. Knowledge, information, and communication. Spread out among planets and stars, they chatted and called and sang. Mr. Zero imagined that he had a face. He imagined that he was smiling. Mr. Zero opened his mind, and a new, shining universe came pouring in.